Hey. I just parked and thought I'd go ahead and go somewhere else. I'm in Memphis. And film it. Cat comes up with, like, if you only have one. And then if I, when I hit this enter, this switches over to here, that changes over there. Mm-hmm. Cross my
X-ray Golf Sierra Alpha, ready to copy IFR clearance to Memphis.
Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra Alpha is cleared to Memphis Airport as filed. Takeoff runway 27 climb and maintain 7,000 feet. Departure frequency is 124.65 squawk 5713.
Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra Alpha cleared to Memphis Airport as filed. Takeoff runway 27 climb and maintain 7,000 feet. Departure on 124.65 squawk 5713.
Cessna Golf Sierra Alpha rate back is correct. Contact ground on 121.9 when ready to taxi. Good day.
Thank you.
Sierra Alpha requesting pushback.
Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra Alpha pushback request accepted.
Seven. navigation settings. The taxi ribbon's on. Let me turn it off. And resume. Now go back. I turn it on, see if it resets it. Seven.
Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra Alpha ready for IFR departure runway 27.
Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra Alpha altimeter 29.921 com. Cleared for takeoff runway 27.
Cleared for takeoff runway 27 Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra Alpha.
Memphis Center on 135.3. Good day.
Going to 135.3 Cessna Golf, Sierra Alpha. Memphis Center, Cessna Alpha Sierra, X-ray Golf, Sierra Alpha, 8,000 feet.
Cessna Alpha Sierra, X-ray Golf, Sierra Alpha, Memphis Center, altimeter 29.92, radar contact, continue to SHAA.
It's going to run out here, and the star is the approach standard something approach. It's like a highway in the sky of vectors. Different altitudes and stuff. Keep things flowing well. And it's got 2.3 miles there. When it gets to Lubbock, it's got 2. So pretty much when I hit Lubbock, I'm going to go direct to that. Because that same as activating the arrival, I'm going to activate it that way manually with the direct to button. Getting close. We'll be at Lubbock. There's a switch. Six, five, four, three, two, one. There's jumped. Okay, now we're gonna go direct two, because that's still blinking. And let's enter and activate. Okay. There's our new path. We're at 8,000 feet. And then that's basically the approach. TOD's top of descent. So you start going down from there. Let me go back out a little bit. I thought that, this one I gotta do the, let's see if it does it. Yeah, it's doing it. But I didn't, the cursor's not there. I gotta get it to show up, but it's not that big of a deal. What is a big deal is I gotta get down. I got 68 miles to get there, so. But I gotta get down to 3,500. Right in our face, but 2 knots, not slowing us down terribly much. So we'll go to altitude. Gotta go down. It's 3,000. It said 3,500, something like that. 3,500. All right. And then we'll hit the vertical speed. And then we gotta decide how much we're going to dive. That's 100, 200, 200 feet per minute, where it's 6. And we'd have to, what's that, about 664 feet. We're going fast. Pull back on the throttle some. And we'll go to 600. Feet per minute. That's a lot. I mean, it's not terrible. I forget how much bring a jet down. Close to 2,400 feet per minute. Not a fighter jet, I mean a commercial type jet. Probably why they call it a heading bug, because it bugs you, because it keeps moving. Okay. All right. Be down to 1,800 feet there to pick up the glide slope. So, see, this is where the stuff comes in that I'm not a pilot, so I don't know. But to keep things from running into each other, you're kind of supposed to stay at certain altitudes. And so, I'm not sure when I should start going down, but I'm gonna go down a little more, a little faster. 58 miles. I don't know, I'm going down to 600. That should do it. So I'll leave that alone. Going west to the west, going to the west from Memphis to Little Rock, Arkansas. We're doing a little northwest, as you do kind of angle up that way. But these highways in the sky, all the vectors that they can use in altitudes, I mean, it's I don't know what they call that, four-dimensional? It's a lot. You got all kinds of vectors out there, but so Yeah, 5.4 miles to get down to 1800. We're doing 107.5. Our ground speed, it's here somewhere. Where's it at? Oh, right. Ground speed, GS. We're doing 115 knots ground speed. It's funny how they have that separated. I guess they usually are a little closer together. But for instance, up at the top here, where the magenta is, they got the waypoint that you see flashing there, which that's fine, but then the distance is over here of 51 nautical miles, and then there's no distance over here, just times. So I would rather have the distance over there too. I don't like that. Well, I guess I do, because this changes here. Never thought of that. That's probably what a pilot would say to me too. He got, we got right there in the flight plan, dummy. Oh, all right. It's getting dark out. I don't know what time it is there. I don't, they'd be in the same time zone, but I don't believe I'm flying real time right now. No, I'm not. It's light outside. And yet then 3,500 and that was kind of an arbitrary number I picked. I'm gonna get down. I'm gonna go ahead and get down to 1800. Speed 200. 22 left at Little Rock. Did I, no, not yet. I didn't contact him. But I guess you're not going to hear him if I got it muted. They canceled my flight, IFR flight plan, and stay visual. Okay, so let me
Little Rock approach Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra Alpha is type Cessna Skyhawk 8 miles north of 2 Alpha 6 3,100 feet. Request flight following.
You want the flight following, so they are keeping an eye out for running into stuff and stuff running into us. An Airbus. It even flares for you. It says retard. All I do is pull a throttle back. Thing lands itself, flares. Pretty amazing. You know, if you think about it, we've had self-driving planes for a long time. You gotta learn how to work it, and then you gotta learn to trust it, and especially like on this simulator, they do get software bugs. And I hate saying frequent, but, you know, more than you'd like. And so every time it seems like they do some kind of update, they cause something else that is funky. So, at first it was tough because I didn't know if I was messing up or if it was messing up. Actually, I thought I was messing up at first. So it's nice knowing when it does something that that's not right. And I'm confident that's not right. So, a lot of that guesswork's taken away. I ran out of coffee just now. I guess I need to drink some water. Downhill and losing speed. it's only 2 knots again, but we've got it. Headwind. We must be doing like, yeah, 270. 283. That FAF means the glide slope to take us down to the front of the runway. And we need to be like where we're at, 1800 feet, you know, thereabouts, to pick it up. We'll see this stuff. Let's go to loke. This will turn green once it picks up that localizer. Might be fairly soon. See the closest. I wanted to know what it was. Plus there were details that show it to me. feels like we're crawling.
Cessna Alpha Sierra
110.70. Yeah, picked it up on there. Okay. called right when we were hitting the ground. That's perfect. Senses speed, we're not going fast enough to get any kind of speed indication. Speed reading. I got a feeling I'm actually going to take off again. Just park here for a minute. deal.